With all apologies to England, the origins of tea date back more than 4,000 years ago to China. According to legend, Emperor Shennong was resting under a camellia tree while his servant boiled water to quench his thirst. Suddenly, a dead leaf from the tree fell into the pot of water. Attracted to the fragrance, Shennong took a sip and was immediately hooked. Whether true or not, tea has had a fascinating, illustrious history that has led it to unparalleled heights. Today, it's the most widely consumed beverage in the world, second only to water.
My name is Bianca Shaw. I'm the marketing and PR director for Chado Tea Room. We are a small family-owned business with four locations throughout the Los Angeles area. Some of the events that we partake in and host are the LA Tea Festival, as well as tea tastings, Japanese tea ceremonies, and various other events in our stores. So tea's history is really unique because of how it kind of came not only to the US, but just around the world in general. It started with a Chinese emperor who was drinking his water, boiling water, and a tea leaf fell into his pot. And after drinking that, he felt awakened, and the story spread around the world of this drink. The British were the ones who kind of brought it into the market around the world, where it was mostly just in China and India, and it's now the second largest beverage drunk in the entire world after water.
In America, tea has experienced unprecedented growth. Over a 25-year period, starting in 1990, the U.S. market for tea more than quadrupled to just over $10 billion. Just how big is tea? The Tea Association of the U.S. estimates that on any given day, more than one half the American population drinks tea. America remains the third largest importer of tea after Russia and Pakistan. Clearly, tea is more popular than it's ever been in this country.
Tea has become popular because people are really looking for a healthier alternative to coffee, as well as not sacrificing their need to be caffeinated and to have that energy that tea gives. Not to mention its antioxidants and all of the other health properties that it has, aiding in weight loss and all other aspects. What differentiates tea from other hot and cold beverages is its ability to latch on to other flavors. Tea itself can, depending on how it's manufactured, can take on so many different tastes: jasmine, smoky, woody, malty. You get all those flavors from tea, and as well as blends. I mean, you have people making flower blends, fruit blends, and it just really can hold on to flavor very nicely.
Today, we're in Torrance, California at Chado Tea Room, a company that has been in operation since 1990, right about the time it started its ascent to the top of everyone's list of favorite drinks. With more than 300 teas from all over the world, Chado offers a variety of flavors and styles for its customers.
Chado began in 1990. When my husband and I first started our business, we walked door to door. He started his importing business, International Tea Importers, and we walked across Chado Tea Room on 3rd Street. And my husband loved it so much that he wanted to acquire that. So in 1994, when the store went up for sale, we purchased it, and ever since then, I've owned it. After obtaining Chado on 3rd Street, we opened a second location in Pasadena. And then from there, we opened up a store in downtown Los Angeles in Little Tokyo. And then from there, we opened up in Hollywood and Highland. And now our newest location is here in Torrance.
Here in LA, where appearances are everything, Chado has been able to eliminate the hoity-toity nature long associated with tea. Instead, you'll find an atmosphere that is relaxed, fun, educational, and even inspirational. Yes, Chado has a traditional afternoon tea for those who so desire, but it also offers tea sommelier classes for those looking to enhance their knowledge of the drink. And it plays host to one-of-a-kind events, such as Japanese tea ceremonies tied to different cultures around the world.
The tea is a unique beverage in the globe, because it relates to a lot of cultures. Just to give an example, there is a Japanese tea ceremony which we saw today, and a Chinese tea ceremony, and even simple example, which is English tea ceremony. So every culture, unlike any other beverage, there is something that they could relate to through tea. And when people come here at Chado, even though we don't do it on a daily basis, we try to do some sort of event related to tea at least once every 3 months. So that just enhance and teach them about what tea could be and how tea is appreciated in other parts of the world.
My name is Mary Hardy. I'm an integrative medicine physician in Los Angeles. I have been sending patients to Chado for years, probably close to 20 years. I met Chado and Rena when I first wanted to find a high quality source for my patients to be able to use tea in a more medicinal way so that it tastes great, but it also is high quality, well sourced, and can really help them create a healthy habit to improve their health. And I was very happy to find Chado, where the quality is great, the people are friendly and helpful, and it's been a lovely partnership for me ever since.
Perhaps more important than its social elements is tea's health benefits. From green tea to black tea to white tea, it has been found to reduce the risk of heart disease and stroke, been effective in preventing certain cancers, and may help slow the progression of age-related neurological diseases.
Being able to teach people and give back to people what we know about tea means everything to us. To be able to be a part of the stepping stones for the tea culture in America is exactly what we started for, is so that people can drink tea, know about tea, start, you know, developing their own culture. And I think that's something that America hasn't quite done yet.
In Los Angeles, Chado Tea Room believes tea is a drink that should be celebrated. So in 2011, its founder and visionary, Devon Shaw, launched the first ever Los Angeles Tea Festival. Though Shaw passed away in 2016, the festival continues, bringing together thousands of people for one weekend in August. They come to lift up their cups and toast to a drink that is unlike any other in the world.